thanks to Miss Donna Gilmore's effort, public awareness of this important issue has increased substantially in the past several years. Miss Gilmore's research was one of the earliest effort identifying and focusing on this important phenomena of stress-induced corrosion cracking, as you can hear. From Mr. Strickland and from Ms. Gilmore, there is a continuing effort from both sides of the fence to drive towards a solution and remedy of this phenomena. Right now, it remains in flux.
There is a large difference in the design of the storage and transportation canisters in Europe, Japan, and the United States, because the canister designs that are used in Europe and Japan are for systems where they reprocess the spent fuel and where the storage time for the spent fuel is short. And so those canisters are designed to be readily opened and closed so that you can easily get the spent fuel back out again. And I've observed in visits to the La Hague facility and their hot cells, fuel assemblies being removed so that they can be reprocessed. In the United States, we have a policy to perform the direct disposal of that spent fuel. And so in designing the storage systems for the dry storage of spent fuel, the focus was on compatibility with the direct disposal of the spent fuel instead of reprocessing it. The major desire in going to a welded shut sealed design was that that would have minimized the amount of fuel handling that would need to occur before placing it into direct geologic disposal. And then if you go to the design, and not to say one thing, this is not discussing whether or not Yucca Mountain is a good idea, but the facility design for Yucca Mountain has the capabilities to open canisters and to repackage spent fuel, but the anticipation is that most or all would go directly into disposal. And that explains a lot of the difference, because the multipurpose canister is supposed to serve for the interim storage, transportation, and ultimate disposal. Changing canister designs in a period of time which is realistic, that is licensing the European design, it's something that we could explore, but I'm not sure that it would in the end be practical, because the multiple functions that we need for the direct disposal approach would mean that you wouldn't be able to directly use the European design for this purpose. But we'd have to look into that. I think that looking at the time scales required to execute Part 72 licensing of a different disposal system, find appropriate seismically qualified location on the site to build the infrastructure, that realistically this could be a very long-term drawn-out process. Simpler solution could be to move to interim storage. If it should be licensed, I have been in public meetings in Carlsbad. It's a very interesting community, quite a bit different from California. I mean, we're different from other parts of the country. And the benefit of having a consolidated site is that you would have local capabilities for opening and inspecting and repackaging, if necessary, spent fuel that could be associated with it. You know, realistically, we have so many decommissioned sites that have already shut down their spent fuel pools. So
Can I just respond to your comment? Okay, these canisters are holding 32, 37 fuel assemblies. Permanent repositories were designed for smaller ones and using different materials such as alloy 22. So these were never designed to just go right in a permanent repository. So that's not a
actually the alloy 22 canisters are designed to for the Yucca Mountain design. they will place these the whole idea was to avoid having to reopen these things, and so the Yucca Mountain design is compatible with.
They're talking about STAD canisters that hold 8 assemblies. So these were not the original. They bought these. I have a DOE report. They bought these because they were less expensive at the time. Was the reason these were bought, and I have written documentation to that effect. In regards of the impracticality of switching, the NRC, Mark Lombard, told me it would be an 18-month licensing process because they beefed up their waste side. These containers meet very high standards, and they have been used for over 40 years in storage. They're no longer reprocessing in Germany, so these are. We have no idea how well these thin canisters are doing because we can't inspect them inside or out. This isn't a matter of is it practical or feasible to do it. We have no choice.
Thank you. Before we move on, I again would like to offer a disclosure. 20 years ago, I served as a federal administrative judge sitting on a licensing board approved the dry cask storage system here at Diablo Canyon. At that time, the chloride stress-induced corrosion cracking was not known to the licensee, was not known to the licensing board, was not known to Holtec. So this is an evolving, entirely new development. I'd like to make that disclosure because Mr. Gerald Strickland served as a licensing manager during the adjudicatory hearing here in St. Louis Obispo. And now let's move on.